Hello friends, I, Dr. Chinu Agrawal, psychologist, director of Feeling Minds and the trustee of HEMA Foundation, will discuss in depth the important topic called creative imagination or ingenuity. Friends, today when we complete our secondary education and graduation and step out to face the world, I mean the corporate world, to seek a suitable job opportunity, one of the important criteria in skill assessment which tops the list is creativity. They are keen to know whether you possess the ability to think creatively on the job. This is their demand for sure. But has our primary and secondary education focused on developing creative imagination within each one of us? One day I was conducting a workshop which was attended by several managers across industries. I assigned these managers an engagement activity. I told the managers that within 30 seconds, they need to draw a sketch of a house. And after you finish your sketch, you have to hold the sketch up and show it to other classmates, I mean the paper on which you draw the sketch. Friends, do you know what was shocking then? All the managers drew the exact sketch of a house which was taught to us during our kindergarten days by our teachers. Are you understanding what kind of a sketch all of them would have drawn? Friends, creativity is developed by our innate ability of imagination. This is an important skill which helps us to innovate due to our creative thoughts and ideas, also called as out-of-the-box thinking. Creativity plays an important role, not just in our professional but also our personal lives. Creative thinking is formed by the open and active thinking minds that we all possess, and they need to be tapped in the right manner to generate creative ideas from time to time. This is how it develops. Creativity helps us to solve different kinds of problems in our daily lives. This is how it helps some of us stand out due to our creative ability. However, we tend to derail from the concept of creativity when we tend to imitate or copy an old and conventional idea to complete a task. That is why creative thinking has indeed become very important. However, for this, we will have to allow ourselves to think with an open mind and accept new unconventional ways of creation. How to use the waste materials in a creative way to make the best things out of them is something I noticed in a place in Chandigarh. If you ever get an opportunity to visit Chandigarh, then you must visit a very beautiful place called Rock Garden, which showcases best from waste art. The artist behind this amazing creativity is Mr. Nek Chand. He has used broken bangles, broken cups, broken plates to create such innovative and beautiful things, which is mind-blowing. What would have led him to create such an art? I strongly feel that our older generations used to always think that we should never waste any pending or remaining material around us, because we faced a lot of difficulties and challenges in our lives. The younger generation today has the best of everything they need in sufficient or rather excess quantities. That is why they don't feel bad when anything gets wasted due to any reason, unlike during our times. However, if we start working to develop the ability of creating best out of waste materials, then we will realize that it has a lot of benefits attached to it. First of all, friends, when we reuse the waste materials we have, this process is called recycling, helps us in protecting the environment, which gives us ample opportunities to contribute to sustainability. In which ways could we develop the ability of creative imagination within us? The first thing that I would like to tell you, especially to the students and teachers, to give complete freedom to the kids to express their ideas and views, because it is the kids who have maximum potential to think creatively. If they wish, they could paint the beautiful sky pink. In such cases, don't point out their mistakes. Instead, tell them that the sky is always blue in color. Let their creative imagination evolve and develop. That is how we all could develop creativity amongst the kids. Be it the colors, the words, the pictures, let our kids' creativity flow and grow. Encourage kids to join hobby classes in school. When they pursue something creative or something that interests or excites them, then that interest brings a lot of happiness to them. They tend to learn new things every time, so they always need to be encouraged by elders. There is one more way to develop creative thinking, which I would like to share. It is very easy to buy a gift from a store. So instead of that, we should encourage our kids to make a birthday card for their friends and relatives through their ideas and creativity. Personalized gifts, which are also called as customized gifts, could be easily made through creativity, which will give them a different kind of happiness. Inculcate a habit of asking questions amongst your children. Many a times it happens that kids ask a question out of curiosity and we immediately ask them to keep quiet. By doing this, it discourages them to ask a question the next time. That is why the kids' quest for curiosity gets suppressed by discouraging them. Instead, we should always encourage the kids to ask all sorts of questions whenever they feel like. Friends, when children start facing challenges, it is that time when they start thinking creatively, and that is how the skill develops within them and they also seek solutions. We should always encourage them by telling that they should not fear challenges. They should face them. The teachers in schools only tend to focus on completing the syllabus. Instead, they could ask kids to solve puzzles and riddles. They could run quizzes and competitions amongst the kids. Please don't ask the kids to copy or imitate any kind of content or model easily available on the internet for school projects. Tell them it is okay if they go wrong. At least they will make an attempt to create something on their own. So similarly, encourage the kids to play in groups and mingle with everyone. This will enable them to collaborate effectively. When they meet their friends, they tend to play, ideate, share their views and learn different things. They tend to come to know of the new perspectives and ideas. All of this not just develops creative thinking within them, but also introduces them to all the required set of life skills, habits and good things. If we wish to develop creative thinking amongst our kids, then we need to accept their power of imagination and also help them to further develop and enhance it. Thank you.